Alright guys, back with the Inspiron 7577, I'm gonna talk about the good, bad and ugly about this computer. Right off the bat, the computer is very thin in my opinion, like it's not bulky whatsoever. So you don't have to worry about that. However, the computer is very heavy, okay, it's closer to 3 kilograms, so if you're a student you may think about that before you purchase the computer. All in all, the overall design is very good. Actually, I'm gonna show you the ports, but I'm assuming you already know about these ports. I'm missing a headphone jack in the left side. It would be amazing if it was available in the left side as well. And because the mouse is more so than off than on the right side. And here are the ports on the right side, and yeah, pretty much every port is on the right side, except the, you see, the headphone jack is right there, so that's nice, I guess. So yeah, this is the home screen, I guess. I'm sorry about the, if I'm stuttering or anything like that, I'm trying to do this in one take. So this is the home screen, I guess, and yeah, I do have the white keyboards, and that's because I'm from Sweden, and the only keyboard available in Sweden is the white version. And it is backlit, which is pretty nice. I don't know if you can tell. How the hell do I shut this? Oh, whatever. Yeah, it's backlit, and this is the home screen, and the bezels are not that bad, okay? They're not bad at all. Like I was thinking it, they were a lot bigger in real life, but they look great in my opinion. And another thing that is great, there is a fingerprint reader on the start button, pretty much. Sorry about the hair, it's a bit messy in my room, but yeah, so you can, it's very responsive, like immediate. Next thing I want to talk about is the screen or image quality. In this case I have a 4K display, and I said it in the comments that I consider this screen as one of the best screens on a gaming laptop. Now I do have the Dell, the XPS. I'm gonna turn it on and give you a comparison. Here is the Dell XPS 13 inch in Quad HD, and this is the Inspiron with 4K pretty much. And I don't know if the video will do any justice, but I think it's enough to give you a brief comparison in size, and I guess in a sense the bezels and the screen quality. In my opinion, like, I don't know man, the screen in real life, like on the, oh, you can see it's buffering on the XPS while this beast is just continuing on with the video, and I have the same network, so that just shows how much more powerful this computer is. In my opinion, this one beats the XPS in terms of screen quality, at least the Quad HD version on the 13 inch, and I think that's because, oh, it's rendering on this one as well, but I think that's because this is a 4K version and this is the Quad HD version. But in terms of size, like, you can see how much of a beast that computer is, so keep that in mind. It's a beautiful computer in real life. Like, they look pretty similar in my opinion. The only thing is the bezels. And obviously the size, this is a 15 inch and that's a 13 inch. But I don't know, it's huge. I was not expecting it to be this big in real life. It's actually so freaking big. It's very heavy as well. And yeah, this one I can pick it up with like two fingers. Whereas this one, I can't even grip it. You know, it's quite heavy. It's like, yeah, it's really heavy, so keep that in mind. I do have the XPS right here, and The Inspiron, obviously. So we can talk about the battery life right off the bat. The XPS is, it has a crazy good battery life. I'm talking like 10, 11, maybe up to 12 hours of battery life with the Quad HD version. And it's very, the portability on this computer is just so good, okay? Whereas this computer, on the other hand, I have the 4K version and I'm getting around 4 hours of battery life. And I don't have the charger with me. I should probably go get it, but the charger is it's quite heavy as well and it's big. So keep that in mind. 4 hours of battery life on this one, 4K version. To me, it's no big deal. I'm bringing the charger with me anyways. I'm having it plugged in. But this one, I can go a full day without even thinking about the charger, you know. So keep that in mind also. This, the predecessor, the 7567, had a lot better battery life than this one. So keep that in mind. It's very powerful, but because of its power, the battery life is not as good, and the battery itself is a lot smaller, so keep that in mind as well. Next thing I want to talk about is the audio, pretty much, and this beast has very good audio. I'm sorry about the lightning. Very good audio. It's very loud, it's very crisp clear. The only thing about the audio is that it doesn't have any bass, you know. It doesn't have that oomph, if you know what I mean. Like, I've heard the Inspiron 7567 in real life, and although the audio isn't as good, I think the bass is, because it has a subwoofer, it's just so much better in terms of